Hey guys, welcome to the second episode of my Chadar Trek series. So today the plan is we have to get our medical checkup done here at this medical center over here. And if you guys need any permits to visit any places here nearby Leh, you need to come here and get the permits. And they also do the medical checkup. As you can see, people from other groups have come here to get their medical checkup done. So they'll do the BP test, oxygen level test, and only once you get through that, you're eligible to go to the Chadar Trek. So we are here to do that. So let me finish that, and after that we are gonna explore Leh Market. So see you guys in a bit. So now we are done with the medical checkup and we cleared all the tests, and once you clear the test you get a confirmation in this kind of paper which we have to show before we start the Chadar Trek. So now we'll just have lunch in a place called Kashmir Khwazan or something, and then we'll go to the Leh Market. So we just had a lunch at Wazwan Palace. It's right in Leh Market at the very end. So if in case you're here, you can try that place. It's pretty good. So guys, before coming to this trek, try and keep yourself healthy, exercise, have some physical exercises in your routine. At least 2 months before you come to Chadar Trek, try and exercise and have healthy food, because the oxygen and BP have to be in its right limits for you to get the permit to go to Chadar. So that's quite important.
The doctor was even asking me what exercise was I doing in the last 1 month. What was I exactly doing? I said cardio,
which was a lie. And as far as the Leh Market is concerned, unfortunately most of the shops are closed because it's winter and tourism is not too high. The peak season starts from June and ends by December. Right now it's Jan, and as I told you guys, the only people seen here are the people who come for various treks in and around Leh. So since the crowd and tourism is less, the shops are closed. But I'll show you whatever I find, because we have to shop for gloves, gumboots, what else do we need? Some trekking poles, yeah.
सबकी ले लो फोटो। ओ हाय, मुझे लगा फिर से कोई बिना मास्क की फोटो लेने आया था, इमीडिएटली बोलते जाओ रेगुलर फेस पे यार,
एज दैट मैं हाय करता हूं,
हां है
वही भी हाय किया, मैं
वही फोटो ले रहे हैं हमारे।
सो दिस इज द आर्मी स्टोर वेयर यू कैन गेट ऑल द गैजेट्स और थिंग्स नीडेड फॉर योर ट्रैक लाइक गम्बूट्स, वुलन सॉक्स, वुलन ग्लव्स और वॉकिंग स्टिक्स, एनीथिंग बीट एनीथिंग यू कैन फाइंड इट ओवर हियर एंड फॉर रीजनेबल प्राइस। सो इफ यू आर इन ले मार्केट यू कैन जस्ट कम हियर एंड बाय व्हाटएवर यू वांट। The main lay market that I showed you earlier, if you just walk and come over here, you will find the army store. There's one over here, one here, and another one over there. So I found this really interesting piece of glass. It looks like this, and whenever you want to record a video on your phone or camera, you can just open it and your fingers will be free. So So it's around 5:30 or 6 now, and most of the shops are closing, and by 7 you'll see all the shops close. So if you're here in winters, make sure that you finish your shopping before 6 o'clock. And another thing is that whatever you need for a winter trek, everything is available here. Down jackets are available for 2000 to 2500, whereas in other cities it's easily above 7000. So any trekking gear, I showed you the army store where you can get things really reasonable at reasonable prices. We bought a woolen socks for just 60 bucks, and also there are woolen gloves here. So in case you miss out to buy anything before coming to Leh, that's totally fine. You'll get everything here. So yeah, that's it for today's vlog. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel and also give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed watching it. See you, tata, bye bye.